it shows the lack of depth of the Divas time is that in 2011, Alicia Fox is the grizzled pro of women's wrestling. It goes the fabulous. It goes the fabulous Moolah, Alicia Fox.
But I will say this. This is a really weird time for women's wrestling because Alicia, like, she gets in 2006, and that's the end of stick them on TV and have them wave their hoots around. And then now you start 2011 from onwards, let's say. They're a PG show. So the women are just there. They're not a function of what the women were there for. What the function of them was, essentially, was like, the men do the violence and the women show their boo-boos, and then that's the whole show.
Oh, yes. No, the Attitude Era, like, yeah, like, keep in mind how...
Buddy, the Ruthless Aggression Era.
No, I was going to build to that, which was, so it's women's wrestling during the Attitude Era. Slut, tits. Ruthless Aggression Era, kill them. Women are bad, they are diapers to be shit in. PG era. well, we have to show that they can read, so I guess, I don't know, have them stand in the ring for a bit. Current era. Oh my God, these people are actually people. Don't trust it.
Yeah, that's the crazy thing, is that, like, I feel like wrestling was posed with a question, okay, you can't treat women as just 100% sexual objects, and then it took wrestling 5 years to be like, oh, then we'll make them wrestle and have storylines. For 5 years, pro wrestling was like, listen, man, I don't know, do they have cooking segments then? Like, what else do they do?
Yeah. Is there a part where they can just take care of me because I'm feeling cold?
Okay, and then we get the wrestler who has the flu, and then they give him ginger ale. I guess that's how the women do on the show.
Okay, where's the part the entire audience cries and the women just go, you're not to blame.